Would it upset you to find out you had a chronic brain condition that caused you to lose consciousness for many hours at a time and periodically experience paralysis and hallucinations? What I've described are the symptoms of sleep. If you live to be 80, you'll spend around 26 years of your life in this state. And yet scientists still don't agree on why. Some say we shouldn't ask why we sleep, but why we're awake when we don't need to be, using precious energy and possibly getting into trouble. The big brown bat is only awake for around 4 hours just after dusk, which maximizes its chances of eating and minimizes its chances of being eaten. But large herbivores have to spend a lot of time foraging and have few places to hide, so they can't afford to sleep more than a few hours a day. If there is some universal function of sleep, a goat somehow accomplishes it in 5 hours, a tiger in 15, and a dolphin with one eye open. Still, there's plenty of evidence that slumber is more than just laying low. A whole host of body functions are enhanced during sleep, from tissue repair, to immune function, to blood sugar control. But the most immediate consequence of sleep deprivation is that we can't think as well. Studies show that people who sleep before and after learning something new perform better on tests of memory and problem solving. This may indicate that the sleeping brain reinforces and archives new memories. But there's also evidence that sleep weakens the connections between brain cells in a way that keeps important information while reducing the clutter. But how exactly this happens remains unknown, and it doesn't explain why some animals sleep much longer than others. Ultimately, some combination of these ideas will probably explain why we spend a third of our lives unconscious. For Scientific American's Instant Egghead, I'm Joss Fong.